Alright, welcome. Day 15, Beech Grove, Tennessee. Checking in here with a video log. It was beautiful. Beech Grove, we were marching out, and it was actually only two of us that day. Other people had to get driven up ahead. They're doing vehicle support. And anyways, we went marching with two people, right? First time since we left New York that two people were only marching, that I can remember. And amazing, because even the feedback with two people was steady, and it was good, you know, and people were coming up to us and asking us questions, you know. The first place that we stopped at, it was a small little, I guess it was gas station. Yeah, it was a gas station, a little Quick Mart, right? We walked in there, and we sparked up a conversation with the lady that was working inside, you know, and we filled up our water bottles, and as we came back outside, she was waiting outside smoking a cigarette. So we started talking to her, you know, and it was such a personal conversation. I think what it was because there was only two people. The conversation was able to evolve from the small talk to something bigger, you know, and that's what happened. It was really cool. It was kind of like what I was always looking for, you know, a personal relationship, but something that happens like organically, you know, and that's what was happening. You know, she was just talking about how, you know, her concerns, you know, and her concerns, she was actually voicing it. And, you know, every time I meet someone and I talk to them, I always ask them, if the conversation gets to that point, you know, what if the politician was standing right in front of you, what would you tell him? And I think because we only had two people marching, that she came to that without me even asking. You know, she was ready to talk about what she would want from a politician without me even asking, you know. And she was just talking about how, you know, the lies from the White House, and how, you know, she didn't even want to vote. You know, and then I started thinking about it, like, I don't think she's alone in that, you know. I don't, you know, she's not. The voices are paralleling something here over and over again. It's an echo almost that I keep hearing. And, you know, after we filled up our water bottles, we had a conversation. We had about a 20-minute conversation with her, and we just started walking away. And it was nice. Because at that moment, as we were walking away, it felt so much more concrete. You know, it felt so much more like there was an impact. And I know the result really isn't even in our hands. I mean, I can't even expect anything, really. I mean, all we do is suit up and show up. And I get that. Yet at the same time, it was like there was something that happened. There was a spark, you know. And yeah, I don't know. You know, it was cool. And I think one of the things that we were learning as we were walking the rest of that day was that it's all about, if you can help. You know, just be willing. You know, if there's an opportunity for me to give my hand, then I will. You know, and the idea is to continually have that sort of, I'm born and raised from the South, but that still doesn't account for the fact that, you know what, being proactive and going that extra mile, you know, and I've been doing it, you know, I want to do it. I look for those opportunities because I know that that's what it is. It's about, you know, paying it forward, you know, doing that extra favor that no one really asks you to do. And I don't mean being co-fucking dependent. I don't mean being codependent about it all. I just mean going out there and giving it a little bit more, give it a little bit harder push, you know. And that's cool. I like that, you know. And you know, just having conversations. I mean, 20 miles that day. 20 miles is a lot of time to spend walking, you know. So a lot of that time we spent talking to each other. And one of the things that I remembered from that conversation was, you know, just talking about how, like, you know, we have to use what's in front of us, you know. And the quote that I picked up was, you know, use the tools of the prison to break free, you know. And I started thinking about that, you know. It's like, that's it. Use social media, use everything that we have in front of us, let's use this to break free from all the chains that we have on, you know. It's like, we can do this, and we have everything that we need to do it at hand. It's here. We don't need anything more. It's like, I used to be in the cycle of, you know, always thinking like, oh, there has to be something more. Something else has to happen. I need this. I need that. And it's not. I don't need anything. I have everything that I need now. It kind of propels me into taking action on a daily basis instead of putting it off, you know. And it was really beautiful countryside. It really was. It was probably some of the best marching that we've done. I mean, it's funny because the days just keep getting better and better and better. They're coming up north, you know, and it's springtime or late winter, early spring, and it's only getting better, you know. And enjoying this countryside weather, and it's kind of engulfing us with like nature, and it's engulfing us with how peaceful it is, really, you know, walking, you know. And I'm not gonna go on a tangent. Anyways, let me wrap up this video log with this story. Okay, we were walking in to the only store in Beech Grove, Tennessee. We met the sweetest lady named Renee. It didn't start off like that at all. We were walking in, you know, put the flag down, and I walked in. It was me and Peter that were marching. I walked in, put my flag down, I walked in, and I saw a lady and two other gentlemen there. And I asked if I could fill up my water bottle. She kind of jeered at me, and she goes, "It's outside." So I ran outside, and Peter went inside, and I ran outside, went to the restroom, filled up my water bottle. Came back out of the restroom, and I was putting my water bottle down. I had a flyer ready to give me, you know. And Peter was already in there talking. So I walked in, and Peter was already talking to these three people. And the conversation was going, how do you say? It wasn't, it was getting acoustic, you know. It was being, bad choice of word, but more, it wasn't being productive. You know, there was crossed arms and intonations of, get out of here, you know, we don't want your kind here. And it's so funny how you can switch it just like that, you know, reframe what happens, you know, to something that we can, you know. Basically what happened was, you know, we walked back in, and we had to change the conversation because it was going downhill. It really was. I was talking about how, you know, the Occupy movement, it doesn't even matter what we're talking about. The fact of the matter is that the topic started going downhill. And so all we had to do is reframe it. And what we started doing, we started talking about what they wanted to see. And instead of us telling them what we wanted, we were listening and what they wanted. And they told us what they wanted, and then we said, well, that's kind of like what we stand for as well, as you started expounding upon that. And it was funny because the whole frame of the conversation just changed from this aggressive to listening to, like, wow, dialogue instead of a monologue, you know. It turned into a dialogue, and it was really powerful because within 3 minutes, the whole energy of the room just changed, you know. And it's funny, she actually had these two gentlemen stay because she was weary of us, because we're travelers and walking into her store. And she told us that. And she was like, "You guys can leave now." So they left, you know. And then so we continued the conversation, and the conversation just kept on getting better and better and better. And I think one of the things that we learned from all that was meeting people halfway, you know. It's like, we have to meet people where they're at. You know, I can't expect everyone to know everything about the Occupy movement. That's not what it's about. But if we meet people right where they are, you know, we calibrate and find out where they are, you know, then we can listen to what they want, and we can understand that we're standing up for the same thing. At the end of the conversation, we were there for about 15-20 minutes. At the end of the conversation, she opens up a plastic bag and pulls open this heated door, and out of this little mini oven comes two sausage eggs McMuffin sandwiches. Throws it in a plastic bag and says, "Hey, I want you guys to take this." And we were just like, wow. You know, there was no other stores behind us. There was no other stores in front of us, you know. And it's like, so clutch. And she didn't even let us pay for it, you know. We were like, no, we can't take that. She was like, "No, I want you to take it." You know, and she was adamant about it, you know. And it was just like, how did it go from this to that? And it's like, within a 5 minute period and then 10 minute conversation, you know what I mean? It was just, I'm telling you, I believe in this. I believe in that. I believe in that 3 minute switch. You know, whatever that was, however we reframed it, you know, I believe in that. And there's something there. There's something powerful there. I can feel it. You know, I don't know where it's going to lead, but I know that if we use that on a larger scale, I know that that's has a source of energy there. I know it has a source of power right there. You know, it's like, let's do that. Let's reframe what we're talking about. And let's say, yeah, we started off with you with your arms crossed, but now watch. Now look what happened. Now look what's happening, you know? It's like we're sharing. We're being a community again. How Renee put it was like family, you know, family and friends. And it was this Beech Grove, Tennessee, day 15. And I'll tell you what, that was probably one of the most memorable marches ever. And I bet tomorrow's going to be even better. Because yesterday was better than the day before that. And today was better than yesterday, you know. It just keeps getting better. And I'm glad I'm on this march. I am. Enjoy your evening. These songs of freedom is all I ever had.